against. I've come to divide. I've come to discern between the right and wrong and expose it for what it is. He told them in verses 2, I believe it is, he said, you're puffed up. That means full of pride and have not rather mourned. In other words, they had repented. They had come to the church. They had shook the preacher's hand. They prayed a few little prayers. Hallelujah. But their sex life was still impure. Hallelujah. Paul said, I've come to church. You're in here, but you're not in him yet. Come on, somebody. Because you ain't got, you've not, come on, somebody. Anybody here holding up? The Bible said in 1 Corinthians chapter 9, I love this scripture, because I know it's 1 Corinthians 6. Amen. And Paul began to preach. Amen. And he says, don't be deceived. The unrighteous will not inherit the kingdom of God. Then at the top of the list, he said, neither fornicators. He called out adulteresses. Come on, somebody. He went as far as to say effeminate. That means a man that thinks he's a woman. Man. Newsflash! Come on, somebody. Go check yourself in the nearest restroom. If you don't got a womb, you ain't no womb man. That means you a man. Anybody here, Holy Ghost? It ain't that hard to figure out. Come on. Even little kids know the difference. Even the animal kingdom knows the difference. That old bug's neck swells up. He goes snorting. Hallelujah. Praise God. He runs after a doe. And if he's running after a buck, it's to run the buck off. Come on, somebody. Come on, anybody here, Holy Ghost. Even creation knows. Amen. The difference. But he goes on and he said, don't be deceived. Somebody said, don't be deceived. You're not going to heaven. Come on, somebody. Amen. If you're sexually impure. Going to 1 Corinthians 6. Paul's preaching this. By 1 Corinthians 5, he was saying, I've come to judge it. I've come to judge within. Amen. God's going to judge the world, but I've come to judge within. I've come in the church, and I'm about to separate, amen, glory to God, the sheep from the wolves. I'm about to separate the lambs from the goats. Come on, somebody. Anybody here, Holy Ghost? Because it's a two-edged sword. You can't preach in my church. And Paul comes in and starts doing that. And then he said, and this is in 1 Corinthians 6, I believe it's verses 9, I was just quoting, and about don't be deceived, and righteous shall not inherit the kingdom of God. And then he gives a list of who the unrighteous are. I didn't write it, don't get mad at me. Come on, somebody. He said, fornicators. You know the word fornication comes from the word foyer. Like the foyer of a building, like the church out there, there's a foyer. There's an entry before you actually come into the main part of the place or the house. During the Roman times, when they would gather together and it was a sport to watch lions kill Christians, and they would burn Christians at the stake. People would gather in those Roman Colosseums in those days, and they would come, and that was the show, to watch the saints be slain. And that was entertainment to them. But often in the foyer, the fornix of the Colosseum, they were male prostitutes and female prostitutes, and for the right amount of money, you could have open sex. Come on, somebody, in the fornix of the Colosseum before you ever entered into the Colosseum where they were killing Christians. Somebody shout, that's where the word fornication come from. Fornix, or the foyer of those Colosseums where everybody was just having sex with whoever they wanted to, and after they had their free sex, hallelujah, they walked into the Colosseum, didn't watch lions eat Christians, and watch Christians be burned at the stake. Somebody shout, it was connected to the killing of Christians and Christianity. And I promise you today, if you think you're saved and you're still having sex without being married, it is not only killing your Christianity experience, it's killing you, amen, with a second death reserved in eternity in a lake of fire. You can cover up the sex sin with a condom, but it's still a sin. Come on, somebody. Anybody hear the Holy Ghost? Hallelujah. And Paul goes on in 1 Corinthians 6, and he says this in verses 11. He said, and such were some of you. Hello? Nobody looking around, nobody. Come on. In other words, he was talking to a crowd. I know you used to do all these things. Hello? You used to be that person. Yeah. Such were some of you. Somebody say, were.
Were.
Do I have to reflect on what the word were really means? It's past tense. Were. Such were. for some of you, he said, but now are you cleansed. But now are you sanctified. But now are you justified, just as if you had never sinned that way to begin with. Justified in the name of the Lord Jesus by the Spirit of God. At 1 Corinthians 6:11. Paul said to those who really got their heart saved, he said three times in verse 11 of 1 Corinthians 6, he said, but you're cleansed. But you're sanctified. It means separated from it. But you're justified. Somebody shout, when your heart gets saved, your butt will too. Somebody's like, don't turn it off. Hallelujah. It's about shout, welcome to Naked Truth.